Hey guys, it's Palmer here, the youth director for Fusion. And I, as we continue on in this time of doing some daily encouragement, I just wanted to say, keep your eyes peeled for some updates from our lay leadership. And also look out for Coop's email tomorrow about some news and some noteworthy things coming up. And also, we're going to be filming a service tonight that we will be able to send out on Sunday to be able to worship together. Today, I just wanted to give us a little encouragement from something that we're doing in Fusion and that I've shared with Fusion, but I wanted to share with the church overall. And so I'm going to read something from Psalms 139, and it says this. This is verses 13, 14, 15. For you created my inmost being. You knit me together in my mother's womb. I praise you because I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Your works are wonderful, and I know that full well. My frame was not hidden from you. And when I was made in that secret place, when I was woven together in the depths of the earth. And I'll continue with 16, and it says, your eyes saw my unformed body. All the days ordained for me were written in your book before one of them came to be. And then in 17, here's what it says. How precious to me are your thoughts, God. How vast the sum of them. So here's something I want to ask each of you, and a lot of you have kids or have had kids and even have grandkids. Have you ever seen a picture drawn by a little kid? If you have, then you know that there usually isn't a lot of skill involved in that creation. But if the art is so bad, then why were so many of your refrigerators covered in drawings by little kids? No parent saves their kids' art because it's award-worthy or professional level, right? Like, you weren't just entering it into contests, but you saved it because it was made with love, attention, and care. You saved it because you loved the one who created it. In the same way, I think we have a tendency to look at ourselves and think of all the things we want to change, right? We tend to see ourselves as messy, imperfect pieces of art. But what if we started to see ourselves as God sees us? In the same way that David, the writer of the psalm, saw himself. What if we saw ourselves as creations made with wonder, purpose, and design? God doesn't look at you and see your flaws. He sees his wonderful creation. And that's exactly how he wants you to see yourself. Today, look in the mirror and thank God for creating you exactly as you are. And even in this time of social distancing and stuff, we may find ourselves around other people, and I want you to see those people you're around as being created by God. So I hope this is an encouragement to you, as it was to me, to know that God created me basically on purpose for a purpose. Thanks.